You can use many tools to optimize for longevity, but one of the most impactful ones is a continuous glucose monitor. In this video, you will understand why a CGM can be an invaluable ally for your longevity journey and how you can use it to optimize your nutrition and life habits. I am Alessandro Carpentiero.
And I am Linda Granfors. We at Beyond Sapiens help you optimize your health and longevity.
If you really want to optimize for longevity, making data-driven decisions is paramount, and a CGM can really help you do that. That's because a CGM provides continuous tracking of your blood sugar levels. It's a small sensor inserted under the skin that measures glucose in the interstitial fluid, which is the fluid around your body's cells. The powerful thing is that the sensor is linked to your phone, so with just a simple scan, you can get an instant reading of your glucose levels and download data from the previous hours. This means that you can see your glucose curve throughout the entire day for 14 days in total, as that's how long a sensor usually lasts. This technology has been life-changing for people with diabetes, but has many benefits for everyone. But don't take my word for it. Dr. David Sinclair once tweeted, saying continuous glucose monitors are only for diabetics is like saying bathroom scales are only for the obese. So now you might be wondering, why should I, someone without diabetes, consider using a CGM? The answer is, it will allow you to understand your current metabolic health and discover your unique glucose response to specific foods, food combinations, and lifestyle choices. This will help you understand how to avoid big glucose spikes and maintain your glucose levels in a healthy range. So why does that matter? Excessive blood sugar levels are associated with oxidative stress, inflammation, and cellular damage, all factors that accelerate the aging process and increase the risk of developing many age-related diseases. In essence, with the CGM, you are equipped with a dynamic tool, not just to manage or stave off diseases, but to enhance the quality of your life. If you want to experiment using a CGM and its connected app, you can get $20 off our partner, Veri, using the code VSM-BeyondSapiens. You'll find all the details in the description. Now, let's hear what Linda has to say about her experience with using a CGM.
So why did I decide to measure my glucose levels? My objective was, of course, to understand the impact of nutrition on my body, but even more importantly, to examine the correlation between my lifestyle, stress levels, and blood sugar levels. By tracking my glucose, I have gained many interesting findings, mainly around exercise, daily routines, and hormonal shifts. Starting with exercise, what surprised me the most was that my glucose remained stable even during my most intense gym sessions, where I felt dizzy, almost out of breath, sure that my glucose levels had dropped. To give some context of what I mean by intense, let's take my leg day with 5 different movements, with weights 3x12 sets where I pressed 200 kilograms in the leg press, for example. If you're curious to have a more in-depth understanding of my routine, our previous video here, Truth About Zone 2, details my longevity training routine. So this surprised me, as I was sure my body was experiencing a drop in glucose, but instead it confirmed to me that my body is efficiently and flexibly tapping into glucose and muscle glycogen stores for energy. It was a positive surprise to get that confirmation of my body's efficient energy utilization and balanced hormonal reaction due to my training, diet choices, and unique metabolic makeup. However, a strange observation was after an intense Pilates session that I ended in a laying position that caused a notable dip in my glucose. This experience underscores the significance of a proper cool down and the need to keep moving post-exercise or refueling to support your body with energy. Next, I wanted to learn how my daily routine and their timing influenced my glucose levels. One significant insight was that my hot shower or sauna in the evening increased my glucose levels. The underlying reason may be that heat impacts blood vessels, insulin functioning, and hydration levels. So now I've shifted my hot exposure to earlier in the evening and ensure I stay hydrated, which has helped stabilize my glucose response to hot exposure. The same happened with my morning cold shower. It spiked my glucose slightly, which is most likely connected to the stress response caused by the cold shock. Talking of stress, I thoroughly zoomed in on hormonal impacts, particularly from stress, as I wanted to better grasp on how stress biologically affects me. A recent feature by Aura, the stress level monitor, came out last week and became very handy in this process. I realized that heightened stress levels or intensity during my day correlated with elevated glucose levels. For instance, I had an intense meeting here and my stress and glucose levels spiked. This is most likely because stress triggers the release of hormones like cortisol and adrenaline, prompting the liver to produce more glucose and elevate blood sugar levels. That's why you should be mindful and strive to reduce your stress levels through mindfulness practices, for example. Also, one note for ladies. The menstrual cycle can impact your glucose levels. For example, during my late follicular phase, with high progesterone, I had more elevated blood sugar, as high progesterone and estrogen levels can cause higher glucose levels. It's intriguing how hormones, whether connected to female menstrual cycles or stress, play a pivotal role in blood glucose management. I can say that yes, it is a bit frustrating to see abnormally high glucose levels due to hormonal changes, but my best tip is to use this data mindfully and try to listen to your body and the signs you see in the data. But remember, do not stress about the data, because that will just make the numbers worse.
You can do many things to improve your health. For me, it all started with focusing on my nutrition. But what I've discovered throughout the years is that no matter how healthy you think you eat, there's always room for improvement. I used CGMs in the past, which has been one of the key factors that made me transition from a fitness-focused lifestyle to a longevity one. At the time, I ate a healthy omnivorous diet and I was in a big calorie surplus. For context, at my peak, I ate between 4,000 and 4,600 calories, depending on the day, and I ate 6 times per day in a 14-hour eating window. So even if my performance at the gym was great and I put on some more muscle mass, that was not really the recipe for longevity. I understood that already by seeing my Oura Ring data back then, but wearing a CGM made me understand at a deeper level that I was not really serving my body with that approach. Fast forward to today, and I'm vegan, on a mild calorie restriction, and I fast every day. I only eat whole foods, but I still wanted to gain additional insights. Specifically, I had 3 main goals for my CGM experience. Understand my glucose response to each meal, tweak meal timing, and understand my fasting blood sugar levels. My breakfast is at 7:30 a.m. and is the biggest meal. Lunch at 11:30 a.m. is my pre-workout meal, and dinner at 3:30 p.m. is the lightest. These timings seem to work great for my glucose response. Also, the foods that I regularly consume didn't cause any unwanted spikes, but that might also be because I'm already adopting specific strategies to reduce the glucose spike. For example, by eating veggies with vinegar first, protein and fats later, and carbs last. I was specifically curious to understand how my breakfast worked, given that it's a pretty big meal with a good amount of carbs coming mainly from oats and fruits. Gladly, that worked great. That's because you are more insulin sensitive in the morning. So that means that your body can process carbs way more effectively than later in the day. I also confirmed something I noticed when I first used a CGM. Chickpeas spike my glucose. Let's clarify what that means. Ideally, after eating, you want your glucose levels to rise gently, peak, and come back down smoothly within a couple of hours. A rise of about 30 to 50 milligrams per deciliter after meals is generally considered optimal for most individuals. So having a glucose spike means that your levels rise above that threshold and they do so too quickly. That's a pity because I really love chickpeas, but at least other legumes I consume daily, such as beans, peas, and lentils, don't trigger an immediate glucose response. So with that awareness, I will try to eat chickpeas less often, and if I really want them, I should reserve them for a pre or post workout meal. This is an interesting point to think of, and it can make you better understand the importance of tracking your glucose. On paper, for example, chickpeas are great and have a very low glycemic index, which is why they're also recommended to people with diabetes. That is generally true, but it does not apply to everyone, such as me in this case. So even if you think you're eating something super healthy, you might still get unwanted spikes. Moving on to meal timing, I found that my early time-restricted feeding protocol works well. What I did notice, though, is that if I postpone my breakfast and prolong my fast, the same meal can have a completely different blood sugar response. So the same meal that got me a score of 9 out of 10 got me a 5 out of 10 when eaten a couple of hours later. So how does Veri come up with these scores? The Veri app gauges your body's blood sugar response to meals on a scale of 1 to 10. A high score means your glucose level remains relatively stable after eating, and that's what we want, while a lower score suggests a significant glucose spike or dip. This rating system considers not just the spike size, but also how long your levels stay elevated. So seeing the difference that meal timing has on my glucose response has been an eye-opening factor in making me stick to my feeding window even more closely. Lastly, I have no medical condition, but I was still curious to understand my average blood sugar and fasting levels, which were quite good. Based on Veri's algorithm, after my first week of use, before implementing specific changes, my metabolic health is adding 4 years to my lifespan. Not too bad. The cool thing about using an app like this is that your score will be constantly updated, so it will help you stay on track and constantly strive for the best food and lifestyle choices.
What you should keep in mind when measuring your glucose levels is that context always matters. I can confess that I was about to go crazy a couple of times and tried to avoid every possible spike, but that is not a sustainable approach nor a healthy one. Changes and fluctuations in glucose levels are normal and healthy. It all comes down to why and how much your glucose fluctuates. So ideally, you should avoid very high spikes and very low drops. However, it's important to note that just because a certain food causes a big spike in your blood sugar, it doesn't necessarily mean that you have diabetes or that you're pre-diabetic. However, tracking your blood sugar levels can help you understand what works for you, your body, and what doesn't. It's important to aim for a consistent blood sugar trend that is not constantly spiking up and down, and what doesn't remain consistently high. This can often be done by having set meal times with comprehensively planned healthy whole foods rich in fiber and protein. When you eat, it's normal for your glucose to rise as you provide your body with more glucose. So what you should pay attention to is not necessarily the spike, but how immediate and aggressive it is, how long does it last, how much does it vary from your baseline, and how quickly does it return back to baseline. Also, from a mental health perspective, stressing about your glucose will spike it even more, as stress increases your glucose levels. So try to have a holistic look at your glucose monitoring and strive for a healthy flow with nice and balanced bumps of fluctuation. Lastly, remember that your glucose levels are affected by a combination of different variables, both internal and external. So try to test things out, give time for yourself, and if you don't see anything directly threatening, do not take the values too seriously before you have enough data to see the bigger picture.
We hope this video gave you a clear understanding of how a CGM can help you improve your health and longevity. Remember that you can get $20 off your CGM order on Veri using the code VSM-BeyondSapiens. While if you're on the journey of improving your health, we would love to work with you. We provide, in fact, an all-in-one solution for longevity through our 3-month longevity coaching program. It's a one-on-one coaching program where you get a comprehensive, fully personalized longevity plan with ongoing support to finally reach your health goals. If you are health conscious and willing to prioritize your longevity, just click the link in the description to learn more about this program and book a free exploration call with us. We would love to meet you.
And if you want to gain new awareness and knowledge to optimize your health and longevity, please subscribe to our channel so that you don't miss our science-based content. Thanks for watching, and we will see you in the next video.